The male inhabitants of an Asian community compete yearly to win nomination to represent this community in the search for the Book of Life. This is a sacred book which one of their founding fathers had informed them to obtain, for it contained the elixir of life and the philosopher's stone needed for wisdom, knowledge, and riches to make their kingdom great among its neighbors. The search for the book is a one-man expedition to be undertaken by the winner under, and this yearly competition is supervised by their king. Since no winner has ever come back, the king gave his support to this young winner by the way of counseling and various sacrifices to their gods, including fortifying him with various charms to defeat ghosts, demons, and evil spirits he might encounter on his journey. This journey took him months, during which he encountered different obstacles, temptations, and tests of endurance. He arrived at his destination and met the book's curator. His attempt to take the book away was blocked by the curator because mankind could only experience the content of the Book of Life. No individual or community or race is allowed to be the sole custodian of this sacred book. He was only given the chance to open and look at the content of the book. This he did, and what did he find? Himself. Inside the book was a mirror, and when opened, we only reflect the image of the holder of the book. He laughed and laughed and laughed and instinctively said, "You are your own Book of Life. There is no other secret to your own Book of Life other than yourself. There is no elixir of life or philosopher's stone but yourself." Welcome to Success Digest, where we simplify and discuss more those ingredients needed for your financial abundance, your financial wellness, and live a happy life. Today, we are going to discuss on the topic, the secrets of success. The secrets of success. We all know what success means. Simply put, is the achievement of a goal, the accomplishment of a set target. Secret means not to be made known, to conceal, or to be hidden. A piece of knowledge that is hidden and intended to be kept hidden. It could also mean something not understood or not known. Today, we are going to discuss those hidden ingredients of success whose knowledge is like light that drives away success darkness and which have been kept away by men of old. Every project, all achievements of mankind start with a thought, a revelation that comes to us in the form of an intuition. This revelation comes from God, a gift which comes in the form of light, an illumination that takes away darkness from the truth. You know, secret things operate in darkness. It comes in diverse forms, some through dreams, some by intuitions, and some by a still small voice. To you, it is just a thought, but as a matter of fact, it is the revelation to your breakthrough. What will take you to your temple of success comes like a spark. You know a spark is a light, but just the beginning of it. For spark to become courage, it must not be left as a spark. It must be used to ignite and become sustainable flame. A good example is a lighter that produces spark, and the candle produces the flame. The same principle is obtainable in the spark plug of a car. When the engine is turned on, it produces little spark and do not work beyond that, but go back and wait for another time when its use will be needed. In Stone Age, they produce flame by the spark from two stones that fall on dry grass. You don't travel with spark. It's only good to start a fire or a light, and that's why it ends. If you cannot transform or translate a spark to a flame, it stops there and you don't have a light. The same thing applies to the intuition that you receive which were not translated to a practical manifestation. They will end there and become a dream, a mirage. You will agree with me that a lot of us falls into this category, thereby killing our dreams, killing our aspirations. Now, how do we convert our spark? Our spark of revelation, our spark of encounter, spark of insight, of momentum experience to become flame that you can travel with, or fire to run and burn for many years. If you fail to translate your sparks to flame, it dies and you return back to darkness. How do we add continuity to the intuition, the revelation of experience that come to us like a spark. The fire that comes from the spark cannot continue as flame unless it can do something that is combustible. Otherwise, you will lose it. It starts to burn something for it to shine. There is need to gather something combustible around the spark like candle to keep the fire alive. It will disappear if this does not happen. In the same sense, what has been revealed to you, that thought of yours which comes as a spark, must be kept alive, otherwise it disappears. As you must provide combustible element for your spark to become flame, so also you must be diligent enough to keep your dream alive. You have to follow the process of idealization that becomes visualization and ends in manifestation. I will now tell you how to gather the combustible around your revelation. Remember, I mentioned that every achievement starts with a thought. Every thought sets the brain cells in motion. At first, the substance upon which the thought is directed fails to respond. But if the thought is sufficiently refined and concentrated, the substance finally yields and expresses perfectly. In this respect, the mind culture must be developed essentially to the highest personal accomplishment which can be acquired. Probably, the most important way to achieve this is through attention or concentration. The power of attention can be more readily understood by comparing it with a magnified glass in which the rays of sunlight are focused. They possess no particular strength as long as the glass is moved about and the rays directed from one place to another. But let the glass be held perfectly still and let the rays be focused on one spot for any length of time, the effect will become immediately apparent. It is so with the power of thought. Let power be dissipated by scattering the thought from one object to another and no result is apparent. But focus this thought through attention or concentration or any single purpose for any length of time and nothing becomes impossible. A single idea, I mean just one intuition, may be worth millions of pounds. And this idea can only come to those who are receptive, who are prepared to receive them, who are in successful frame of mind, who have ready the combustibles upon which their spark can be transformed to flame and continue to burn. Every individual created is endowed with the capacity, the ability to make money for his or her existence. Your ability endowed on you may not be the same with mine, but surely you are endowed with one to make money for your existence. Consider the animal kingdom, the cat families like lions or the eagles that are carnivorous and endowed with strong claws and teeth to catch their prey and tear them into pieces. But not so with the set of animals that feeds on grass like elephants. They have no claws. The same with mankind. Each of us has the ability to obtain what we need for survival. The problem with most of us is that our spark never becomes flames. Either through ignorance, carelessness, or procrastination, we fail to convert our sparks to revelation, to intuition, to flames of fire that are portable and can withstand the test of time. Every big fire starts with a spark, but not every spark becomes a big fire. Every big fire starts with a spark, but not every spark becomes a big fire. Nothing happens without a cause. Hence, a man who knows how to control any situation by bringing adequate causes into play will always win, and we never know why we know exactly why. But the ordinary man who has no definite knowledge of cause and effect is governed by his feelings and emotion. He is doomed to fail. Such always thinks chiefly to justify his action. So, when he fails as a businessman, he says that luck is against him. When he lacks friends, he says his individuality is too fine to be appreciated. He never thinks his problem through to the end. He does not know that every effect is the result of a certain definite cause, but seeks to console himself with explanations and excuses. He thinks only in self-defense. Follow your mind. Follow your instinct. How many times have we arrived at wrong conclusion only because we fail to follow our instincts that has initially directed us on the right path? It is only the man who knows how to control situations using adequate causes we arrive at the desired result, the desired effects. Let your light shine, but you have to make available the combustible objects that will translate your spark to that light that will shine. God will supply the ingredients, but you have to cook your dinner yourself. God will supply the ingredients, but you have to cook your dinner yourself. In life, there are two sets of people, the simple and the achiever. The simple lacks suitability, subtility, no craftiness. They see things as it is, and they are not ready to add value to their advantage. They hardly behave wisely, and a small zone is a comfortable zone to them. But not so with the achiever. It's different. It tends to succeed. It's a winner. The achiever don't just look at things and see what it is. He look at things and see what they can be, what they can become, and take advantage. Let me share the story of two men who grew up together with you. One was Mr. Simple and the other one Mr. Achiever. From college, the two entered the same university and graduated as economists. They both got married and each had his son. Here hence their similarities. While Mr. Simple joined the civil service and became an employee, Mr. Achiever set up a manufacturing firm and became an entrepreneur. Mr. Simple lives on average life and within his income, which hardly cover the family expenses. His son, while growing up, usually approached his father for those things boys normally desire to have, like bicycles and so on. But he always met the same constant response from the father. We say, you know that that would be beyond our budget. Not the same with Mr. Achiever's son. It was not that his request would be supplied immediately, no. The father will ask him to go and work in his factory to cover the cost. One day, Mr. Simple's son asks his friend, why should his father always fail to give him his desires while Mr. Achiever supplies all his friend's desire? His friend corrected him that he worked to get his needs. Although his father is rich, but he has told him that the only way to appreciate his possession is to work to obtain it. The man who desired gold don't fold hands. He who desires gold don't fold hands. Of course, Mr. Achiever's son introduced his friend to his father. He too started working at the factory and used the proceeds to get his desires with no expectation anymore from his daddy. The two sons grew up to become successful entrepreneurs. Your road to your success starts in a thought, like a spark that needs combustibles in the form of actions for the flame to continue burning. This discussion, the full discussion on this topic, I've published a book titled, the same title as today's topic, The Secrets of Success. What I've just discussed here is just a tip of the iceberg of this important exposure of the secrets. You'll find more exposed in the book. I recommend it, if not for yourself, also good for yourself, but for your youth. The knowledge of the content of the book is a light to their path in the journey of life. The book is available in both Kindle and in paperback at Amazon's Books. You can also get it directly from me, the author, and very soon it will be available from our website, kinetsconsultlimited.uk. Let us continue to travel together on this journey of success through the paths of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed, and not to be informed is to be deformed. My name is Kayo Denrighton, and I can be reached on 074-2794-2000 or 07951775255. Better still, visit our website, like I said earlier on, kinetsconsultlimited.uk. kinetsconsultlimited.uk. If you are blessed by this video, please subscribe, share, and like. Also, visit our blog on YouTube for more of our videos. And don't forget to buy the book, The Secrets of Success. Please enjoy your success.
Welcome to Success Digest, where you obtain ingredients for your financial abundance and financial wellness and be fully financially independent. Let us travel together on this, our journey of success, through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed. Not to be informed is to be deformed. Success Digest leads you to financial independence.